Got an update. This is one of the saddest things in the world. Elijah McClain, remember, he was arrested. He was then basically put in an ambulance. He was killed. And the officer who threatened to put a K-9 on him is now rehired. Let's put his picture up full mass. This was one of the saddest stories I covered. The Aurora Police Department has now rehired the former K-9 officer, Matthew Green, who's on the right, who in 2019 helped restrain the young Elijah McClain and even threatened to unleash his K-9 on him during the stop that led to the young man's death. Green was hired on January 10th to the rank of patrol officer, according to the city hiring documents obtained by the Sentinel through an open records request. Green is not, one of the officers facing criminal charges in connection with McClain's death. Many disagree with that decision. But he was named as a defendant in the 2020 lawsuit filed by McClain's parents against the city of Aurora and 15 first responders. The lawsuit settled $15 million in 2021. That's called defunding the police because of bad police conduct, all right? Now, let's put up the mother. Here's what's happening. Elijah's mother, Shaneen McClain, was upset Green had been rehired and told the Sentinel, "In my opinion, everyone that was there that night and did nothing to help my son stay alive are all accessories to my son's murder." I agree with your sentiment. She also added that Green was an for taking on the slave mentality of telling a person of color they're going to be attacked by a police dog. I have some of the audio, we'll play it in just a moment. Green arrived with several other officers at the scene as backup in North Aurora. This was August 24th, 2019. After McClain had already been tackled to the ground, restrained and handcuffed by initial responders, an independent investigation of the stop shows that Green threatened McClain, saying that he would use his police dog. Remember, McClain did nothing wrong, he did nothing illegal, and he died because of their actions. Here's some of that video.
If you keep messing around, I'm gonna bring my dog out, he's gonna dog bite you. You understand me? Keep messing around.
Quit messing around. He was doing nothing wrong. He was confused as to what you were doing. Shortly after that, the report said Green replaced Officer Jason Rosenblatt in holding down McClain's legs. Let's go ahead and put up the individuals. I want to briefly recap the tragic incident. McClain was detained and placed in a chokehold during an encounter initiated by the Aurora Police Department. The officers you see, Randy Rodema, Nathan Woodyard, and Jason Rosenblatt. Paramedics Peter Kucinich and Jeremy Cooper injected McClain with what investigators now describe as an overdose of ketamine. The 23-year-old was handcuffed and restrained on the ground. McClain went into cardiac arrest and 3 days later was taken off of life support. In 2021, a state grand jury indicted the 5 first responders for felony manslaughter and criminally negligent homicide, in addition to lesser crimes. Also, in 2021, the city entered into a consent decree with the state attorney general's office that requires APD to implement 70 different reform mandates meant to break a pattern of excessive force and racial bias. How did this happen? How does a guy who obviously is completely outside of protocol, may have even been the catalyst to why a lot of this happened, and a person so controversial that community members and leaders are still saying he should be fired and charged with a crime? How did he get away with being not charged? All right, so this controversial individual, he gets rehired. APD hiring is conducted by the city's Civil Service Commission. which is responsible for the hiring and discipline of police officers and firefighters independent of the respective agencies. The commission has faced criticism in the past by police reform advocates for overturning firing or discipline decisions made by the police chief. Now, this is ironic, isn't it? Under the terms of the consent decree, it must make as much of the disciplinary process public as possible and change the hiring process so new recruits meet with their hiring agency sooner. Let me go to the spokesperson of APD. Matthew Longshore said Green applied for reinstatement during the tenure of interim chief Dan Oates, who preceded current interim chief Art Acevedo. Longshore said Oates endorsed Green's reinstatement and forwarded the matter to city management, and that the Civil Service Commission ultimately signed off on Green's hiring. This has got to stop. Elijah McClain was one of the most innocent human beings you have ever seen in your life. He was a sweet soul. Every officer involved, every paramedic who decided to engage in negligent behavior that led to the death of this young man should absolutely face the music. Giving this cop his job back, I'm talking to the city of Aurora, giving this cop his job back shows exactly who you are. It shows the community who you are. Please understand, you are literally forcing the community to pay the salary of individuals who are oppressing them. You are making them finance their own oppression. Now, this is why the us and them relationship continues to permeate. Leadership does not require genius, it requires heart. And when you see actions like this that seemingly lack heart from every agency involved and every person who made a decision, why would you ever believe the community would trust you? Why? If you're working on trust, stop rehiring people who are not. It's that simple. All right, watch the thoughts here.
This is obviously a miscarriage of justice. If this guy's not facing criminal charges, okay, then you can just say, well, we don't have the sort of legal juice to take the guy down. Certainly, he shouldn't be allowed to go out and carry something like this out again. Look, I'm somebody who, I think the standard for people to lose their jobs in this country should be quite high, considering that we have no social safety net. And if you're not working, you're basically done for. However, I think taking the life of a very young person for no damn reason sort of should meet the standard of maybe you shouldn't have that job that you were in while you were in your capacity to do that. That seems to be obvious to me. Even as somebody who thinks the standard for people losing their job should be high, killing a kid on the job, that kind of reaches the standard for me. So to me, this is obvious.
Yeah, we will see if a correction is made or if somehow they see the light and they force this guy to resign. We will continue to follow it as it develops. Shame on you all for doing this to that family.